Come, let us kneel down, worship and adore Him. Ooh, come, let us adore Him. Kneel down, worship and adore.
We worship the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Emmanuel, the greatest gift that was sent to man.
Humble and whole. was a great gift to man. Yeah, this was the greatest gift to man. I thank God for the gift that he gave to the world on that special day. Our baby Jesus is what we needed, just to show us our sinful way.
He was born in a manger,
all right,
so meek and lowly.
Grew up to be a man.
Oh, yes, he did.
Humble and holy. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. This was the greatest gift to man. Yes, this was the greatest gift to man. I sing hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah.
Thank God for that special day.
I sing hallelujah.
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 Jesus.
Jesus. Show me the way with love and power.
And power. Understanding,
and forgiveness,
grace,
peace, holiness, and righteousness.
Sing hallelujah,
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 hallelujah. This was the greatest gift to man. Yeah, this was the greatest gift to
hallelujah,
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 Jesus, thank you, Jesus, say
hallelujah,
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 Jesus.
church say amen?
We must work while it is day, spreading the word of God as we go along the way. We must be willing to do God's will, spreading the word of God till it reaches throughout the hills. We must witness to everyone we meet in every song we sing. We must tell them of a soon coming King.
We must work while it is day, spreading the word of God as we go along the way. We must be
must work while it is day, spreading the word of God as we go along the way. We must be willing to do God's will, spreading the word of God till it reaches throughout the hills. We must witness to everyone we meet in every song we sing. We must tell them of a soon coming King.
We must work while
stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. The thrill of hope. new and glorious morn.
Oh. Amen. Let church say amen. Amen. Let me say once again, Merry Christmas to all of you. And for those of you who have sacrificed the time to come to worship on this day that the Lord has made, for some of you had inquired if we were going to have worship today. Well, friends, this is our day of worship. And it just so happened that Christmas falls on this day. Amen. Father, we thank you for the opportunity of worship. We thank you, God, for the men, women, boys, and girls alike who have gathered once again to worship your holy name. We thank you, God, for the spirit of Christmas. We thank you, God, for family, for friends. We thank you, God, for your spirit that is, abides and dwells in our hearts. We thank you, God, for your word. And even now, Lord, we pray that you will open our ears that we might hear your voice, that we might see you all around us as you open our eyes that we might see you clearly. Lord, we say thank you. We thank you, God, for this day that we call Christmas, the day that we celebrate your birth into all the world. Lord, thank you. Thank you, God, for Jesus Christ. And even now, Lord, speak to us in Jesus' name. Let the people of God say together, amen. From the Gospel of Matthew, the second chapter, verses 1 through 12, and then the Gospel of Luke, the second chapter, verses 7. From Matthew, the second chapter, verses 1 through 12, the Bible reads, "Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, 'Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him.'" Lord have mercy. "When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. So they said to him, 'In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, for you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod, when he had secretly called the wise men and determined from them what time the star appeared, and he sent them to Bethlehem and said, 'Go and search carefully for the young child, and when you have found him, bring back word to me, that I may come and worship him also.' When they heard the king, they departed, and behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them till it came and stood still where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshiped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to him: gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then, being divinely warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed for their own country another way. And then the seventh verse of chapter 2 in the Gospel of Luke. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. I want to use as a subject in this message, find room for Jesus. Find room for Jesus. The birth of Jesus was a supernatural event that changed the world and forces a response by every human being who has or will ever live on earth. Do you need a Savior? Do you need a Savior? Is Jesus your Savior? Yes or no? Think with me for just a moment of your child, your first child. The birth of our four children has changed our lives forever. We will never be the same. I'm telling you, my wife, Evie, and I every day I'm asking God to help us. Our children have made a profound impact on us. One at Morehouse, two at Hoover High, and one at Gwynn Elementary. Three boys and one girl. At birth, we smiled, we cried, we cheered. There were hugs. We called our friends and told them about the birth of each child. What a moment! We touched them. We hugged them. We smelled on them. It smelled so fresh, so new. We held each one of our children with tender care. We sterilized every fork and spoon. We bought the best little onesies and twosies and threesies and tried to use them till they outgrew each of them. They were cute. It was like time paused for all of us. We counted toes. We counted fingers. The 9 months plus wait was over. It was a big deal. You know how it was with you. Like for us, it has changed us forever. Our children, they changed us for the good. Think about the birth of Jesus. Think about Jesus coming into your heart, coming into your life to live with you forever and forever and forevermore. Today, my brothers and my sisters, rise up on this Christmas day and be a person of joy. Be a person of exclamation. Be a person of triumph. Be a person of confidence. Be a person of expectancy. Be a person of celebration. Listen up. Jesus is born. He lives. The Savior is here. Amen. We proclaim to the world. We proclaim to our communities. We proclaim to our friends, our co-workers, that Jesus is the Christ, the risen Savior of the world. Hallelujah. And even at Christmas time, friends, I've come to remind us today that at Christmas, as we find room for Jesus, the thing about Christmas is that Christmas is a time to seek Jesus. I don't know about you, but friends, I want to know, where is he? What is God saying through Christ? People need the Lord. People are still seeking Jesus. People want to know, is there really a Savior of the world that these Christians are proclaiming? The Magi, they came, the Bible says they came from the east seeking the Messiah, seeking the Savior of the world. The word Magi described these men as astrologers, as magicians, as sorcerers. They came from Babylon, they came from Persia, they came from other places of the world. They believed the stars held the truth to the future. But consider, they came seeking Jesus. If there were ever a time in the history of America, America needs to know Jesus. Amen. Birmingham needs to know Jesus. Amen. The state of Alabama needs to know Jesus. United States of America to the end of the world need to know Jesus. Amen. The Bible says in 1 Chronicles, the 16th chapter, seek the Lord. Look for the Lord and his strength. Seek his face continuously. The Bible says, I love those who love me, the Lord says, and those who diligently seek me will find me. You want to know the Lord. If you are seeking after truth, seek Jesus. And the Bible says, with your whole heart, we will find him. The Bible says in Jeremiah, the 29th chapter, you will seek me and find me when you search for me with your whole heart. The Bible says in Matthew, the Gospel of Matthew, the 6th chapter, verse 33, but seek ye first the kingdom. And as we seek the kingdom of God, we are seeking after truth of Christ and Christ's righteousness, that we might be men and women right here in Birmingham as we celebrate the birth of Christ, as we seek Christ. Friends, at Christmas time is a time of worship. Listen what the Bible says, Matthew, the 2nd chapter, verse 2, the Bible says, for we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him. Friends, I am grateful to you that you've come today to worship the true and living God. Friends, as we celebrate Christmas, this time of worship, do you not know that most Christian scholars believe that the Magi, they travel more than 1,000 miles on their journey to see the newborn king? That's incredible! Consider us, we struggle coming just a few miles to worship. They travel 1,000 miles plus. Can you imagine the weather they faced, the days and weeks and months they traveled just to see the newborn king? I hope that this Christmas day and every day as we walk and live with the Lord Jesus Christ, that we celebrate his birth every day. That even though we celebrate and we have December 25th set aside, every day is Christmas in the life of the believer. Oh, the Bible says in Psalms 95, 96, oh, come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord. That's what worship is all about. Being in the presence of God, adoring him, giving thanks to his holy name. Jesus said in John, the 4th chapter, Jesus said, the hour is coming and now here when true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. The Bible says, and when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshiped him. Do you ever find yourself falling prostrate before God Almighty and declaring him to be your God as we are his children? Friends, the Bible says when Jesus was born and heaven celebrated, it was plural. Pay attention. The angels were singing. How many? The Bible says, listen, in Revelations, the 5th chapter, verse 11, the Bible says, then I looked and heard the voice of many angels, numbering thousands upon thousands, and 10,000 times 10,000 100 million angels all were bringing the message, He is born. Can you even imagine the angels declaring, He is born? What about the people of God as we say to the world around us, our friends, we declare before them, He is born. Imagine the scene. Jesus is born in a quiet, still manger, and heaven erupts behind a choir, 100 million, circling the throne of God, singing in harmony, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild. God, great God from Zion, and sinners, you and me, are reconciled, are brought back together, that we can worship together. Friends, the shepherds heard it. Six of heaven knew, have heard it. At Christmas time, we seek Jesus. At Christmas time, we worship. At Christmas time, it's a time of sacrifice. Listen, you may say, listen, in Matthew, the second chapter, verse 11, the Bible says this, and when they had come into the house, and when they had opened their treasures, their gifts, they presented him, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Listen, think for a moment. What really did they sacrifice? They sacrificed their time, and they sacrificed their gifts. They gave their very best to God. Listen, it is believed that this journey took up at least to 2 years. Listen, you know what Herod said? That's why Herod decreed all male children would be killed. And so after this long journey, perhaps 2 years or more, they made a sacrifice to go and see him. They brought expensive gifts, this gold and this incense and this myrrh. It was their time and treasure that the Magi sacrificed. So we say to you today, what will you give? What will you sacrifice to God? Will you give him your tithe, your offerings? Will you give him your talents, your abilities? Will you give him the best that you have at Christmas time? Your love, your commitment to one another, seeing to the end that the gospel message go forth all the way to the ends of the world. The Bible says in Luke, the 9th chapter, whoever wants to save their life will lose it for the sake of following Jesus. Listen, when you invite Christ to come into your heart, you give your best to him that he might use you to share the good news of the gospel with those around you. And the Bible says in the Luke, the 2nd chapter, verse 7, and she brought forth her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. Listen, I believe our Lord was laid in the manger where the beasts were fed. I mean, not only the cattle of the field was fed, to show that even beasts like men and women may come to Jesus and Jesus will save them. Even at Christmas time, you and I at times would say there's no hope for them. But I want to encourage you to know, yes, he can. Despite our sinful ways, Christ can do what we cannot do. He can save us. He can raise us. He can cause us to be not second to none, but we can cause us to be men and women who are his disciples. Right here in Birmingham. Friends, dear friends, it is too much the case that there is no room for Jesus. I mean, you know, there's some questions about, you know, was it really an inn? Was it just space? But listen, friends, the Bible says there was no room to lay the Lord Jesus. and they laid him in a manger. In building strong marriages, we must find room for Jesus. Living a single, celebrative life, we must find room for Jesus. In building strong, small businesses, we must find room for Jesus. If we're going to build strong communities where we live, move, and have our being, we must find room for Jesus. In the midst of raising children, we must find room, God Almighty, for Jesus. I can't raise those children. We can't raise our children without the help of God. In the midst of injustices, we must find room for Jesus. In our day-to-day conversations with one another, we must find room for Jesus. In the midst of sin, whatever they may be, we must find room for Jesus. We must find room for Jesus in the classroom. I tell my son, you know, listen, you may be over there, but listen, boy, listen, you better find some room for Jesus. I was in college. We were in college once before, but you gotta have some Jesus in you. In our neighborhood, we gotta find some Jesus in us. Friends, in the midst of jealousy, in the midst of rage, in the midst of anger, in the midst of envy, we must find room for Jesus. In the midst of dating, we must find room for Jesus. In the midst of our intellectual arenas, we must find room for Jesus. In the pulpit, we must find room for Jesus. In the choir stand, we must find room for Jesus. In the pews, we must find room for Jesus. In the life of every congregation, we must find room for Jesus. There must be room for Jesus. There is no room for us to take ease. We are soldiers of the cross. You will find no ease in our life warfare because we believe in Jesus. There is no room for us to sit down and be contented with all of our attainment, for we are travelers with Jesus. Last but not least, friends, I've come to say to us at Christmas time that Christmas is a time to seek Jesus. Christmas is a time that we worship. Christmas is a time that we come together and find our time of building relationships. You know, it's amazing that here these men travel more than 1,000 miles to see a baby. But the story doesn't stop there. The baby not only was born, but the baby grew in stature, grew in wisdom, and it was these men who came to pay homage, to bow down and worship the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. And it was this man that these magi, the three wise men, found themselves starting a new relationship. What about you today? You know, is it possible to start a new relationship with those around you? The Bible says this. In Isaiah, the Bible says, "And they shall call his name Wonderful. They shall call his name Counselor. They shall call his name Mighty God. They shall call his name Prince of Peace, Everlasting Father." What do you call him today? On this Christmas day, beloved, will you call him Wonderful? Will you call him Counselor? Will you call him Mighty God? Will you call him Prince of Peace? Will you call him Everlasting Father? Wouldn't it be a great testimony to you if there were one of you today who gave their life to the Lord Jesus Christ on Christmas Day as we celebrate his birthday. Amen? Amen. If you're here this morning and you want to walk with the Lord Jesus Christ, we invite you to come and worship with us.